Hypocalcemia is a condition where the calcium level in your blood is below normal. Clinical presentations for hypocalcemia may range from muscle spasms to seizures. The treatment depends on the underlying cause as well as the acuity of the hypocalcemia. Here are some conditions that you cannot miss. Hypoparathyroidism. Hypoparathyroidism may be hereditary or acquired. Acquired causes include neck radiation, post-parathyroidectomy, dialysis, infiltrative diseases such as sarcoid, amyloid, and metastatic cancer, and poly-glandular autoimmune syndrome. Hereditary causes include DiGeorge, Kearns-Sayre, and Kenny-Caffey syndromes. Surgical. Surgical correction of hyperparathyroidism, extensive bowel resection, and removal of the pancreas may lead to rapid bone remodeling and osteoblastic activity that outstrips the rate of osteoclastic activity. This is called hungry bone syndrome. Vitamin D deficiency or resistance. Vitamin D is a necessary cofactor in PTH activity. Vitamin D deficiency is usually due to poor dietary intake or supplementation, chronic renal or hepatic disease, poor sunlight exposure, or impaired gut absorption. Hypomagnesemia. Severely low magnesium levels as a result of renal or GI losses may result in hypocalcemia with low or normal PTH levels. One needs to restore magnesium to proper levels in order for the parathyroid glands to release PTH and thereby correcting the calcium levels. Hyperphosphatemia. Conditions such as critical illness, iatrogenesis, renal failure, rhabdomyolysis, and tumor lysis syndrome will result in phosphate binding to calcium causing hypocalcemia. Hypoalbuminemia. Serum calcium can be in ionized form, which is physiologically active, or bound to albumin. Conditions that increase the body's albumin, for example cirrhosis, renal compromise, sepsis, burns, etc., may lead to low calcium levels. In these situations, the ionized calcium level is measured to determine if the patient is truly hypocalcemic. Medications. Many medications may lower calcium levels. Common ones include chemotherapeutics, bisphosphonates, anticonvulsants, biologics, immune suppressants, bowel preps, diagnostic imaging dyes, red cell transfusions, and proton pump inhibitors.